just a dreamy world up there. Dear friends in higher places, carry me away from here. Travel light, let the sun eclipse you, 'cause your flight is about to leave. And there's more to this brave adventure than you'd ever believe. Bird's eye view, awake the stars, 'cause they're all around. Above the thunder, but you can fly anywhere. Purple burst of paper burst, this picture paints a thousand words. So take a breath of myth and mystery, and don't look back. Bird's eye view, awake the stars, 'cause they're all around you. Wide eyes will always brighten the blue. Chase your thank you.
Rakyat Yang Berbahagia Tan Sri Datuk Seri Utama Arshad Ayu, Chancellor, INTI International University, to deliver his address.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Selamat pagi. Graduates, members of the Board of Directors and member Board of Governors, faculty and staff of INTI, parents, family, friends and distinguished guests. It is with great honor I cordially welcome you to INTI's convocation ceremony for the graduating class of November 2019. I would like to start by conveying my heartiest congratulations to all our graduates today. This is a momentous milestone to you and for those who have supported you throughout your academic journey. As a community, we celebrate your accomplishments. Indeed, your achievements today reflects INTI's core purpose of nurturing visionaries, innovators, and leaders with great values and skill. As you embark on the first steps towards your next goal, allow me to speak about the impending change that the world is now experiencing. We are all well on our way into the fourth industrial revolution, otherwise known as IR 4.0. This has been defined as a new phase of using interconnectivity, automation, machine learning, and real-time data to carry out our tasks that once required human attention. Unlike the preceding industrial revolutions, IR 40 will truly change the way we work, the way we live and play, including the opportunities we as human talents now bring to the table or to the fore. You have witnessed to yourself the rapid expansion of the digital world. Technology has made it possible to have new products and services that increase the efficiency and enjoyment within our lives. Ordering a car ride, booking a flight, buying a product, making a payment, listening to music, watching a film, or playing a game, any of these can now be done remotely. Even the teaching and learning landscape is being revolutionized through technology. You would have utilized tools such as INTI's online learning, management system, and various other technologies. With these, you were able to learn in an engaging manner befitting the 21st century, we have helped you to gain your scrolls today. Thanks to the rapid progress of technology, there are also new subjects that I would never have imagined in my youth, almost 90 years ago, subjects such as biotechnology, cybersecurity, cloud computing, Internet of Things, data science, digital marketing and e-commerce are now readily available to all students and taught right here at INTI. I have also heard of the fantastic work being carried out through the use of INTI's 3D printers and laser machines at the Fab Lab, and augmented reality and artificial intelligence is changing the way today's students carry out advanced research and innovation. In actual fact, nearly every scientific field has reached new dimensions unheard of during my time as a university student. Dear graduates, while IR40 will make us think the roles that humans and machine play, and as business embrace digitalization, I would like to remind you that even the most advanced technologies should complement rather than replace human skill and human thinking. With the rise of IR 4.0, uniquely human traits, curiosity, creativity, empathy, problem solving, and communication are more important than ever. In a continually changing market, employees who possess these soft skills can help their organization adapt and compete in the ways that machine cannot. Ultimately, robots will not and should not take the place of our innate sense of morality. We must be careful to not digitalize humanity and disconnect us from our heart and soul, which is the core of what makes us all human and what gives us a sense of purpose in life. So now, dear graduates, let us take a moment to reflect. I invite you to ask yourselves, what is my core purpose, your core purpose? Try to look ahead to 20 years from now and ask yourself some of these questions. Firstly, when my glory is written, what would I like people to say about me? And question number two, what will be my contribution first to my family, to myself, to my community, and to my profession, and to the world around you? Dear graduates, I sincerely hope you urge to find your core purpose and contribute your share in shaping the future. The world you inherit is full of challenges, yet you have the greatest opportunity to be builders of a new world as you work alongside a vibrant network of engagement individuals. I implore you to continue nurturing your own ethical values and intellectual heights, and always look for opportunities to make important contribution both in your careers and to your communities. Use the knowledge and skill you have gained to bright light to those who may be lost in the darkness. But don't forget, there are core values which is very important. You must be honest, your integrity, and above all, your transparency. These are the three core values you should always take it with you when you leave this hall, the hall of INTI. As you conclude this important phase of your lives and begin a new journey, this is the time to appreciate those who have contributed to your success today. Remember the tremendous support you have received from family, friends, and benefactors who have made it possible for you to pursue this remarkable academic journey. With us today, we are also members of the faculty who have guided and mentored you. They have shared their time, knowledge, and expertise to help you reach the important milestone. I would like to especially thank these faculty members and other supporting staff for having worked hard to fulfill not only the aspirations of their students, but also of INTI. So congratulations to the graduating class of November 2019, and to all parents, family, and friends who are here to celebrate these graduates' achievements. We hope to hear from your successes in life, and we encourage you to impart your wisdom to fellow INTI students in the future. Thank you.
Thank you, Yang Berbahagia Tan Sri Datuk Seri Utama Arshad Ayub. Ladies and gentlemen, INTI International University proudly announced the conferment of Emeritus Professor to Datuk Dr. Rahmah Muhammad. I would like to invite Associate Professor Dr. S. Gita Subramaniam, Head of Program from the Faculty of Health and Life Sciences, to read the citation.
Chancellor, I present to you Dato' Dr. Rahmah binti Muhammad. Chancellor, my fellow colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, Yang Berbahagia Dato' Dr. Rahmah Muhammad has been instrumental in the journey towards making INTI International University one of the most established universities in the country. In her role as Vice Chancellor of the University from 2014 to 2017, she focused her efforts on building a community of learning where student engagement, team spirit, diversity, and inclusion were paramount to the university's development. Her goal was to encourage growth in areas that promote collaboration while focusing on productivity and sustainability. Her many initiatives include the establishment of numerous centers of excellence, and who can forget the Midnight Madness Dash in which Prof. Rahmah was the one right in front, tea sessions with students and staff, and activities that prioritized community inclusion and community service, including initiating the establishment of the Yunos Social Business Center, YSBC, at INTI, to foster the development of social enterprises here in Negeri Sembilan. As an academician, Dato' Dr. Rahmah's research in the field of bacterial pathogenesis and microbial genomics have led to both national and international accolades, including her receipt of the Third World Academy of Sciences Young Scientist Award, the National Young Alumni Council, the 2015 Distinguished Alumni Award by the Malaysian Australian Alumni Council, the 2015 International Alumnus of the Year Award by her alma mater, the University of Queensland, and the British Council PMI2 Award. Dato' Dr. Rahmah was also one of the pioneers of Meliodosis Research Group at University Kebangsaan, Malaysia. Her contributions to the advancement of biological sciences was acknowledged with her election as a Fellow of the Academy of Sciences Malaysia. Since then, her extensive work in this field has manifested itself in many avenues, from patents and the commercialization of her research to successful partnerships with structural biologists from all over the world. Dato' Dr. Rahmah's journey to greatness began upon her graduation from the University of Queensland in 1986, where she obtained a PhD in biochemistry. After completing a Bachelor of Biomedical Science degree at the University of Portsmouth in United Kingdom, she returned to Malaysia to take up an academic position in the Department of Biochemistry in the Faculty of Life Sciences at UKM. She went on to serve as the Deputy Vice Chancellor of Research and Innovation at UKM for 5 years before taking on her role as Vice Chancellor of INTI International University for 3 years. In January 2018, Dato' Dr. Rahmah was appointed as the Chief Operating Officer for the Malaysian Qualifications Agency, MQA, a position she holds to this day. Throughout her prolific career, Dato' Dr. Rahmah has always maintained that the research career in molecular biology requires passion and perseverance, that the outcome of research takes time and there are no shortcuts in the journey towards excellence. In recognizing her patience, dedication, and efforts in celebrating diversity and individuality, INTI would like to honor Dato' Dr. Rahmah with the title of Emeritus Professor. Emeritus Professor is an honorary title in recognition of distinguished academic services and exceptional contributions in academic leadership at a university. It is a prestigious award, ladies and gentlemen, and is not therefore conferred lightly. We graciously invite Dr. Joseph Lee, Vice Chancellor of INTI International University, and Ms. Wong Siu Fong, Registrar of INTI International University, to don the ceremonial robes for Yang Berbahagia, Datuk Dr. Rahmah Mohamad.
With great honor, I would like to invite Yang Berbahagia, Emeritus Professor Datuk Dr. Rahmah Mohamad to give her acceptance speech. And please join me in welcoming Yang Berbahagia, Emeritus Professor Datuk Dr. Rahmah Mohamad. Thank you.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim, and a very good morning to everybody. The Chancellor, INTI International University, Yang Berbahagia Tan Sri Datuk Sri Utama Arshad Ayub, the Vice Chancellor Dr. Joseph Lee, members of the Board of Governors, CEO INTI Education Group, graduates, academics, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to thank INTI International University, in particular its Board of Governors and the Senate, for conferring me this honorary title of Emeritus Professor. I am humbled by this honor. You may remember me, graduates, when I welcomed you to the campus 3.5 years ago during your explorers and many events. So 3.5 years ago, I accepted the post of Vice Chancellor and promised to nurture INTI International University like a coveted child of my own. And today, my beloved child, INTI IU, honor me with this prestigious recognition. This occasion is also special as I received the scroll from our iconic educator and prominent civil servant in the country and a great mentor, our beloved Chancellor Yang Berbahagia Tan Sri Datuk Sri Utama Arshad bin Ayub. It's a very special day for me. My dear students, I would like to start with the wise words from Lao Tzu, a great Chinese philosopher. He said, "A journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step." Today, on your graduation day, I offer my heartiest congratulations to those who are graduating. Your professional journey begins today. I graduated in 1980, 39 years ago. I have discovered that life is all about learning, unlearning, and relearning. We never stop doing that, and we'll do it until we are at the age that who we are today. Continue to furnish yourselves with the latest knowledge relevant to your professions, as described by Yang Berbahagia, our beloved Chancellor, but also on other subjects that are relevant to being great citizens of Malaysia and globally. Today, in the 21st century, we know that innovation drives economic success. A great university has four assets that drive economic success: intellectual property, such as patents, advanced research, center of excellence, and business incubators. And most importantly, her graduates, bachelors, masters, PhDs. INTI International University has all the four assets. For example, as described earlier by my colleague Dr. Gita, the establishment of INTI Yunos Social Business Center, of which the patron himself is Professor Mohamed Yunos, Nobel Peace Prize and owner of Grameen Bank Bangladesh. INTI is the first private university to establish such centers. Congratulations, INTI. I'm very privileged to be part of the university management and faculty in the development of all the assets that we have today at INTI. INTI University leaders do continue to further innovation in the campus so that we continue to prosper our students, families, which will lead to prosperous Malaysia. Dear parents, staff, and graduates, the value of a good university education is not so much what is poured into you, but what is planted that really counts. In this context, INTI core values of three I's: internationalization, innovation, and individualization, coupled with three C's of communication, collaboration, and creativity, give students the INTI edge in employability. I was so happy to look at the poster where 90% of our graduates are being employed. I am truly proud of being part of INTI that upholds student-centric values, and where I am now at MQA, Malaysia Qualification Agency, and the Ministry of Education, INTI's name resonates well in the organization and the government as institution of higher learning that is student-centric and industry-facing. I will always continue to preach INTI student-centric values to anybody who wants to listen to me. As we nurture our students' potential, we must never compromise on one of life's true values, that is integrity. As you become leaders, teachers, businessmen, civil servants, politicians, never sacrifice integrity for other spoils of life that may come your way. In the words of Warren Buffett, looking for people to hire, look for three qualities: integrity, intelligence, and energy. And if they don't have the first, the other two will kill you. So graduates, instill the three values as you journey on. My dear graduates, your journey from now onwards, you will face, as Yang Berbahagia and our beloved Chancellor says, many challenges and impediments. I would like to share with you what it takes to continue to succeed. It is what I call having a Nobelist mindset. There are such examples like Nobel Prize winners, successful entrepreneurs, CEOs. They have specific mindset with characteristic in three main areas: persistence in the face of challenges, seeing connection between ideas and that others do not recognize, and creativity. In the words of Al-Kindi, great philosopher, mathematician, geographer, and chemist, one must not be afraid of new ideas, no matter the source, and we must never fear the truth, even when it pains us. I am sure some of you today have already inculcated such mindset and to please continue it throughout your working life and personal life. Person with such mindset will always have a positive attitude and it is infectious to their colleagues, bosses at work and family members too. It is a positive energy you carry around you, doing what you love and loving what you do. You are the living icons of INTI and giving back to society through volunteerism, care for the underserved and the environment. It is my wish list for graduates today to have such values. Finally, as you enjoy your graduation day with family and friends, you will soon spend a lot of time thinking and planning for your career. So go ahead and make your plans. But do not forget that the planning is just the beginning. It's hard work, dedication that makes a career. An example is our beloved Chancellor, Tan Sri Arshad Ayub, an epitome of this paradigm. Success requires dedication and being bold in taking chances. Just to share with you, when I was young, my father advised me. He is just a simple kampung man. He told me, whatever you do, always aim for the sky. And if you fall, you will land on the coconut tree, the tallest of trees in the kampung. So now you are in town, you will aim for the sky, but look for the elevator so that you will come down gracefully. As I grow older and get more sophisticated from a kampung girl, I continue to search for such parallel of what my father told me and found it in the words of great Chinese philosopher Zhuangzi. For the wise man looks into space and he knows there is no limited dimension. Be young and wise, set forth to greatness. Our prayers are with you all the way. Thank you. God bless.
We would like to invite Yang Berbahagia Tan Sri Datuk Seri Utama Arshad Ayub, Chancellor INTI International University, to present a bouquet of flowers to Yang Berbahagia Emeritus Professor Datuk Dr. Rahmah Muhammad. Thank you, Yang Berbahagia Tan Sri Datuk Seri Utama Arshad Ayub, Chancellor INTI International University, and Yang Berbahagia Emeritus Professor Datuk Dr. Rahmah Muhammad. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Wong Siu Fong, the Registrar of INTI International University, will now present the class of 2019 for Bachelor Degree and Diploma Program.
Recipient of INTI International University Bachelor Degree and Diploma, please rise. Chancellor Yang Berbahagia Tan Sri Datuk Seri Utama Arshad Ayub, I present to you the recipient of Bachelor Degree and Diploma from INTI International University Class of 2019. They have successfully completed their academic requirements and passed all prescribed examinations.
By the power vested in me by the INTI International University Board of Governors, I hereby confer the certificates to the recipient of Class 2019.
Recipient of INTI International University Certificates, please be seated. The deans of the faculties request leave to present their candidates.
Chancellor, I present to you graduates from the Faculty of Engineering and Quantity Surveying. Bachelor of Civil Engineering Honours, Ang Jia Eun. Chai Yen Hao. Chang Wenbing. Wu Jinjun. Qiu Jiepan. Lu Shuying. Ang Chi Sing. Tan Jia Jun. Yap Sing Yu. Ahmad Alabras Nidal. Ahmed Alim. Ahmad Muhammad Yuhusan. Chai Jing Singh. Chiu Wei Xian. Jin Tian Yin. Chu Li Rong. Gan Ji King. Ge Cha Kai. Guo Zhengping. Q Kai Men. Lam Guo Bing. Lau Hong Wang. Lee Jarvin. Lim Guan Xing. Ang Jun Bing. Ang Guo Tai. Ang Tian Xiang. No Kawamato Arif Binti Muhammad Arifin. Parashi Dawada. Hua Chen Xiang. Guan Yong Hao. Shami Sotana. Sim Jia Qin. Xiao Jia Min. Yap Xiao Ping. Yong Ki Wai. Yong Sheng Jie. Yun Chi Yin. Bachelor of Mechanical Engineering Honours, Chu Sheng Jun. Gan Zhi Yong. Goh Eng Ho. Ho Ka Yong. Tan Chi Yong. Tan Hui Xian. Yap Jia Yong. Chan Wai Piang. Qing Yu Shuo. Zhu Shati. Devendran Nair Anak Lelaki Ravi. Ismail Ragesh Saad Al Jaberi. Hugh Man Chun. Koo Ming Ren. Kai Rong. YY Lee Yun Yin. Liu Chin Lee. Lim Ji Kyung. Lim Jun Xie. Lim Meng Tak. Ng Kai Wen. Nofara Akila Binti Zaina Kamarudin. Hui Jia Yuan. Pun Zi Lin. Sharil Shaquan bin Muhammad Sobri. Shavendran Pillai Analelaki Ganesan. Yong Ming. Sundar Raj Analalaki Sundra Moody. Tan Sei Ren. Tang Peng Ru. Wong Ratnau Kisa. Wong Wei Jin. Wu Wing Xiang. Bachelor of Quantity Surveying, Elvis Wong Shen Jie. Chiu Ji Hong. Ding Dong Wei. Eda Ng Bo Yi. Kit Shang Ren. Kurt Sing Yen. Lee Chun Ho. Lee Yi Xuan. Ang Su Yi. Tan Se Hui. Yap Ji Shan. Ang Ka Heng. Brandon Wong Jun On. Chao Bing Yi. Ching Jin Jin. Chong Li Zhen. Qian Pei Xin. Chin Karen. Zhong Yun Jian. Qin Shu Hui. Zhong Yi Xian. Daniel Ko Ji Hao. Derek Ko Chi Xiong. Anali Binti Robin. Hon Yong Chuan. Sun Qian. Gok Lei Yi. Lian Pek Si. Li Kit Yang. Shu Wei. Lim Chui Li. Lim Jing Tai. Lim Sun Yik. Low Kai Chia. Muhammad Rashid bin Rusli. Ming. Ang Ru Yun. Ang Teng Yi. Ong Chong Yeo. Hua Yi Ting. Xie Pei Ni. T.E. King. Teo Hazel. Wong Chi Hao. Wong Xue Qing. Yong Li Xin. Yong Wei Qi. Adrian Lau Chuan Ming. Diploma in Civil Engineering, Devendran Ananalaki Arumugam. Te Zhi Xian. Diploma in Quantity Surveying, Ang Wei Han. Angel Lai Ching Ro. Chong Bi Shi. Kavaresh Binai Analaki Ganesan. Sai Chuan Wei. Tommy Lim Wen Cheng. Wong Shu Ki. Yap Chi Hao.
Chancellor, I present to you graduates from Faculty of Information Technology. Bachelor of Computer Science, Chong Kuo Liang. Chong Wei Hong. Jesse Tay. Ku Ka Yen. Lee Yu Wen. Pang John. Timothy Tan Rung Hua. Ting Le King. Dong Ming Hui. Chang Si Hong. Chin Moon Ching. Christopher Kok Wai Kin. Yi Yong Shen. Kok Chia Hao. Li Sun Sheng. Li Zhen Yang. Leong Wei Xin. Liu Xian Zheng. Lim Jiang He. Lim Li Wai. Bachelor of Information Technology, Lim Tek Kian. Mia Sing Yi. Nicholas Daniel Analaki Anton. So Jen C. Tan Jun Hong. Tan Yong Jia. Tan Ji Xian. Tang Jun Jie. Te Jing Yang. Te Wei Ni. Eden Jiwon. Kriti Nandu Analaki Ramdas. So Wai Fin. Diploma in Information and Communication Technologies, Putri Yashivya Noviriana.
Ladies and gentlemen, now I would like to invite Mr. Michael Gabriel Smith up on stage for a special performance. Michael is one of our students and he will be singing for us. Let's put our hands together for Michael.
Seem crazy what I'm about to say.
Make it loud.
Sunshine, cheese, tea, gotta take a break.
A little bit louder.
Hot in movies, I'll go straight. With the air, like I don't care, baby, by the way.
Louder.
Because I'm coming along if you feel like you won't be quiet. Come along if you feel like that's what you wanna do. Come along if you know that happiness is for you, hey. Come along if you feel like that's what you wanna do.
gotta take it first. But give me all you got, no holding back. Well, I should probably want it, I'll be just fine. No offense to you, don't waste your time. Hear that, cause I'll come along if you feel like a room without a roof. Come along if you feel like that's what you wanna do. Come along if you know that happiness is for you, hey. Come along if you feel like that's what you wanna do.
Okay.
Of Happy. Chancellor, I would like to present the Industry Award to the outstanding graduates. This Industry Award is a distinctive award given by our industry partners and multinational corporations in recognition of our students' excellent performance in their academic studies, extracurricular leadership, and being innovative in the development of their research projects. May I now invite Mr. Rajaramkrishnan, Head of Operations and Service Management, AID Technologies Malaysia Sendirian Berhad, to come on stage to present the AID Technologies Malaysia Sendirian Berhad Award for Best Student in Computer Science. The award is a cash check for 1,000 ringgit, and the award goes to Mr. Timothy Tan Rong Hua. Thank you, Mr. Rajaramkrishnan. May I now invite Mr. Tony Yee, CEO Ingermark Malaysia Sendirian Berhad, to come on stage to present the Ingermark Malaysia Sendirian Berhad Award for Best Student in Mechanical Engineering. The award is a cash check for 1,000 ringgit, and the award goes to Mr. Ho Ka Yong. Thank you, Mr. Tony Yee. Now, I would like to invite Engineer Chong Soon Fat, Principal Advisor, GNP Water and Maritime Sendirian Berhad, to come on stage to present the GNP Water and Maritime Sendirian Berhad Award for Best Student in Civil Engineering. The award is a cash check for 1,000 ringgit, and the award goes to Mr. Lu Shu Ying. Senior Chong Soon Fat. Next, please welcome Ms. Tan Lin Na, Acting CEO INTI International University and Colleges, to come on stage to present the Institution of Mechanical Engineers UK Award for the Frederick Burns Waldron Best Student Award. The award is a plaque and certificate, and the award goes to Mr. Ho Ka-yung. Next is the Institution of Mechanical Engineers UK Award for Best Project. The award is a plaque and certificate, and the award goes to Ms. Tan Hui Shun. Thank you, Ms. Tan Lin Na. Next, we will present the university prizes. I would like to invite Professor Dr. Damien Foster, Head of School, Computing, Electronics and Mathematics, Faculty of Engineering, Environment and Computing, Coventry University, to present the Coventry University Award. The Most Outstanding Student Award goes to Mr. Lee Yu Wen. Thank you, Professor Dr. Damien Foster. Ladies and gentlemen, we will now continue with the presentation of scroll to the graduates.
Chancellor, I present to you graduates from the Faculty of Health and Life Sciences. From Bachelor of Biotechnology, Lo Yuqian. Chai Ning Xin. Choi Kim Sang. Aileen Ho Cheng Yi. Gita Pucharappa. Tan Chiu Li. Madeline Ratimala Mikau. Ng Pik Ling Jacqueline. Sherlyn Varatharajan. Shamia Hosanali. Tang Wen Liang. Vishalin Ravichandra. Yu Hai Ping. from Bachelor of Physiotherapy, Alfonso Chu Kersing. Chai Pei Shang. Colin Yap Yu Chuan. Tan Hui Tang. T. Jia Bing. Ahmad Hafizuddin Bin Jalil. Angeline Ong. Chen Yangxin. Cho Ken Boon. Darmila Krishnasamy. Go Wang Yi. Kenneth Aso Anak Lelaki Raja. Lau Jinghui. Lee Yilin. Lee Ju-an. Ma So-ju. Muhammad Daniel Adam bin Muhammad Najib Budi. Natasha Shahira binti Ibrahim. Eng Xing Yi. Nur Vanessa Sharis binti Abdul Rais. Riyasa Hawa. Xin Hui Chan. Tang Ying Ying. Tang Zhong Sheng. Vanessa, anak perempuan V. Selvan. And Yit Pui Ying. Thank you, Chancellor.
Chancellor, I present to you graduates from the Faculty of Business, Communication and Law. Diploma in Accounting, Alice Ng Yi Sin. Chua Siu Yi. Feng Wai Yan. Lai Pei Ni. Thank you. Dr. Yarasi, anak perempuan Suguma. Tan Wai Run. Tan Singh. Tang Xiaoying. Woon Si Moon. Yong Yi Ping. Diploma in Business. Armil Hamza bin Muhammad Jamil. Aoyang Xianzu. Bei Xue Ying. Cham Jia Hui. Chan Xue Yi. Chia Pei Cheng. Chong Chun Ming. Ding Chi Ming. Yi Yuan Ying. Fong Chui Yi. Gan Xuanping. Gao Qiping. Jian Zhen. Lai Xin Xin. Li Qi Ken. Li Jia Hui. Ding Pong. Li Yan Yan. Liu Bi Yan. Liu Xiao Shuan. Lim Xue Ying. Lim Wei, Lim Wen Xian. Lim Man Fei. Lindsay Lim Xiu. Luke Isaiah Das and a lucky Edmund Das. Marvin Chin San Rong. Muhammad Cairo bin Abdullah. Noru Hafiza binti Nazri. Xia Ji Wei. Sofia Rahman bin Muhammad Nazim. Tai Ro Shen. Tan Huo Ming. Tan Wen Ting. Tan Zhen Hao. Tang Xing Zi. Tio Zi Xuan. Tao Teck Wei. Victor Chi Yong Hao. Wong Gin Ying. Yu Kai Er. Yip Sing Yuan. Lim Ya Xian. Cha Jin. Diploma in Mass Communication, Anis Nadira binti Muhammad Faris. Charlene Chong Kai Lin. Xia Xue Wen. Crystalline Nazarita, anak perempuan Abraham. Divya Tashini, anak perempuan Nagan Terran. Yong Jia Xing. Ariana Chong Zian. Jaya Rahman anak laki Subramaniam. Joanne Q Yu Han. Lee Shen. Muhammad Aiman bin Muhammad Isha. Muhammad Noru Irfan bin Jamal Muhammad. Natalia Samudra. Nordini Natasha binti Rosli. Sam Wee Ching. Siti Noreza Fira binti Muhammad Rizwan. Bai Xingjie. Bai Zunki. Win and Ricky Agnes. Wong Xuanji. Yap Fei Yi. Yi Han Yan. Xiu Ki Wen.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Wong Siu Fong, the Registrar of INTI International University, will now present the award of degrees of the university in absentia.
Chancellor, I present to you in addition for the award of degrees of the university in absentia, those candidates whose name appear in the order of proceedings but who have not been presented in person at this ceremony.
By the authority vested in me, I admit these candidates to certificates of the university in absentia.
Thank you, Ms. Wong Siu Fong. Ladies and gentlemen, this ceremony would not be complete without a valedictorian speech. In this convocation, Mr. Colin Yap Yu Chuen from Bachelor of Science, Honours in Physiotherapy program will be giving the valedictorian speech representing the graduation class of 2019. Colin Yap grew up in Subang Jaya, joined INTI International University to pursue a career in physiotherapy, one which he deemed to be a noble career pathway and one which could help him realize his dreams and aspirations. Being able to help others get back onto their own feet one step at a time was a personal calling for him. His time with INTI enabled and empowered him to practice the science of physiotherapy in many aspects. He was involved in events such as the Breast Cancer Awareness Campaign in his first year, the annual World Physio Day events, as well as committee member for INTI Physio Cup. He was also involved in clinical practices in hospitals such as Hospital Sungai Buloh and Hospital Rehabilitasi Ceras. These contributed into molding him into the physiotherapist he is today. His personal life motto is to always be humble and learn from mistakes, stand up and be stronger than before. A guide instilled in him by his parents, his greatest mentors. Ladies and gentlemen, let us warmly welcome Colin Yap on stage.
Yang berbahagia Tan Sri Dato' Sri Utama Asha Ayub, Chancellor of INTI International University. Yang berbahagia Emeritus Professor Dato' Dr. Rahmah Minty Mohamad. Ms. Tan Lina, Acting CEO of INTI International University. Dr. Joseph Lee, Vice Chancellor of INTI International University. Dr. Damien Foster, Head of School, Computing, Electronics and Mathematics, Faculty of Engineering, Environment and Computing, Coventry University. Members of Board of Governors, INTI International University, INTI Management Team, ladies and gentlemen. That's a lot of people, all right. So a warm welcome and good morning to everyone gathered here today. It is truly a celebration of achievement and success of all the graduating cohort in November 2019. Truly, many of us have dreamt of this day where we sit here in this hall, wearing our robes, wearing our motorboards. And as for parents, of the day that their child has achieved excellence, what does it mean to be graduating? It means that this is not the end, but rather the beginning of a new chapter in the book of life. And with all books, We learn, we gain knowledge through the pages of the endeavor, filled with twists, filled with turns, ups and downs, challenges, each failure a mistake, just another paragraph that leads to improvement and success. With INTI, the slogan, education that empowers, is not just three words confined to the walls of this university, but extends to the vast unknowns of life. The empowerment that comes from the university, its lecturers, societies, and overall cohesiveness of its peers is one of the most vital tools that I have personally learned in my 4 years here. These years have not been a breeze, but rather a gust of wind that has needed to lift us to higher places and to propel us into a brighter future. Memories made from classes, sporting events, team projects were truly essential in molding me into the person I am today. Parents, families, and friends of all graduates here today, today is a landmark of achievement in my fellow graduating cohorts' lives as well as yours. Because without the support, dedication, and love from all of you, today would not have been a reality. I am certain that the pride you feel for your child only proves the sacrifices that you have made. A special mention to my parents, William and Veron. The years of coaching and nurturing me through the thick and thins of life were truly the beacon of light that guided me through. Almost as bright as the whites in your hair, hopefully not from the stress that I caused. To all lecturers from all faculties, your expertise, wisdom, long-suffering with us have been a shaping force in our time here. From the bottom of our hearts, we want to thank you and let you know that through all the pressure, your students have become diamonds in the rough, harder than any substance this life can throw at us. We apologize for all those late assignments and the stress marking our papers. Hey, we did it and we are all here today. Fellow graduates, let us show our appreciation to our lecturers and our mentors. Please join me as we rise. Let us give a huge round of applause to everyone here on stage for the years of dedication and hard work. Graduates, thank you. Please be seated. Graduating, it is more than just an achievement and success. It is a celebration of life itself, being able to hurdle through the ups and downs, standing back up when we are knocked down. Today, I urge all of you who have received your scrolls to stand here proud of the people that we have become and make it a personal life motto to be the best we can. The pursuit of life itself is one that requires constant learning and perpetual self-growth. It may be cliche to say, but it is true no matter how long the journey takes. There will be days where we may feel this is not true. I encourage and implore you to embrace these days. These are the days that make us human. Let me end by reciting this poem called The Guest House by Rumi. The guest house represents us, represents our workplace, our lives, the people around us, where the guest is the experiences we go through. This being human is a guest house. Every morning, a new arrival, a joy, a depression, a meanness. Some momentary awareness comes, an unexpected visitor. Welcome and entertain them all. Even if they are a crowd of sorrows who violently sweep your house, still, treat each guest honorably, because he may be clearing you out for some new delight. Be grateful for whoever comes, because each has been sent as a guide. Graduates of November 2019, congratulations and all the best. May everyone achieve excellence and success chase after you all. Thank you.
Now, I would like to invite Ms. Tan Lin Na, Acting CEO INTI International University and Colleges, to present a bouquet of flowers to the valedictorian. Thank you, Ms. Tan Lin Na and Mr. Colin Yap Yu Chuen. Ladies and gentlemen, we thank you for attending today's ceremony and sharing this proud moment with all the new graduates. We would also like to thank our dedicated staff and students for the gamelan performance throughout the event. I now invite the Chancellor to adjourn the ceremony.
I now declare this convocation ceremony adjourned.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the academic reception. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. We have now come to the end of this morning ceremony. Before we end this ceremony, I feel honored to announce that the tassel of your mota board is specially designed and made at INTI Fab Lab. As INTI graduates, you can remove the tassel and take it home with you as a convocation gift.
Goodbye.